hello on Tuesday the 3rd of October, and the Reverends Jason and Alan and all of the St. Luke's team hope that everything is still going well for you and your families. Our opening sentence, awaken us, Lord, to your love, your light and your leading. Amen. Our readings today are from Ezekiel chapter 11, verses 14 to 23 and Psalm 73. Yesterday I touched a little bit on how castles are defended against enemy attack. Usually a considerable fight is put up in defence of the building, although when things aren't going as well as hoped for, sometimes a tactical withdrawal is made. This form of withdrawal often allows for a situation to be reassessed and people regroup. Although I do have to say that this approach is far less likely to happen when property is involved. Also, strategic withdrawals are usually short-term in length. The vacating of the temple premises and the conquest of Jerusalem are all part of God's strategic plan. And in God's case, this isn't a short-term measure. I know that on several occasions I've touched on the fact that the exile from Jerusalem lasted a lengthy 70 years. That's the amount of time needed by God to be certain that the people had given up their stubborn ways and their hardness of heart towards him. God wants them to have a new heart and a new spirit. And when we think of it, 70 years is such a long time, and so much can happen in it. If we think back 70 years, our late queen had only recently started her reign. And just think of everything that happened during the time of her reign. I think that it's because it's such a long period of time that God now provides the Israelites with early notice and a promise that they will eventually return home. Our next prayer. Gracious Lord, we continue to pray for everyone who is in a position of leadership of any kind. As the weeks go by, the complexity of the situation and the decisions which need to be made don't become any easier. With that in mind, we ask that you pour down your wisdom on all leaders, and we pray that they follow the guidance which you give. Amen. For today's prayer points, let's pray for people who are displaced from their homes and country. Pray for good relationships within families, and pray that godly truth and justice is defended. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. I do hope that you enjoy the rest of your day, and our blessing. May God's light guide you, God's hand support you, and God's love surround you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you and remain with you today and forevermore.